Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today in this video, we will discuss about Mqtt protocol. Mqtt stands for Message Queue Telemetry Transport, which is essential for IoT application. In this video, we will discuss how we can establish communication between a Raspberry Pi and ESP8266 nodemcu using Mqtt protocol. So let's start. In this video, we will cover basics of Mqtt, set up Mqtt broker server on Raspberry Pi, basic testing of Mqtt protocol, set up Micropython on ESP8266, Micropython code for Mqtt client, and then the final testing for Mqtt communication between Raspberry Pi and ESP8266. Mqtt is a lightweight publish-subscribe network protocol that transports messages between devices. Mqtt protocol defines two types of network entities, a broker server and number of clients. Broker server receives messages from clients and routes them to the appropriate destination clients. Clients are nothing but any devices that are connected to the broker server. And that clients can be either a mobile phone or a smart bulb or any electrical appliances which runs on the low power. When clients want to publish a message, it sends a control signal to the broker server. The control signal contains name of the topic and message. Then broker server broadcasts this message to the network. And the connected clients which are subscribing to that particular topic will receive the message. So in this video, for Mqtt broker server, I will be using a Raspberry Pi where I will set up the Mqtt broker server, which is Mosquitto server. And then I will use an ESP8266 nodemcu as a Mqtt client. Enough theory, let's start with the practical.
In order to set up Mqtt server on Raspberry Pi, first log into Raspberry Pi. Then update the Raspberry Pi using sudo apt update. Once the update is done, then install two library packages, sudo apt install Mosquitto and Mosquitto clients. Okay, so once done, then we need to enable the auto startup of Mosquitto server once the Raspberry Pi is restarted or reboot. Okay, to do that, you have to write down this command sudo systemctl enable Mosquitto dot service. So this will enable auto startup. Now your Mqtt broker server is ready. In order to test the Mqtt service, here I'm using two SSH windows of Raspberry Pi. One window I'm using as a publisher, which will send data, and another window I'll be using as a subscriber, which will receive the data. So now let's set the first window as a subscriber using Mosquitto underscore sub command, followed by the topic test. Now, from the second window, I'll be publishing data to the topic test using Mosquitto underscore pub command, followed by topic test, followed by the message. Now, as you can see, once I publish the data, hello world, from the receiving side, it appears here. So this way, MQTT protocol can be used to communicate between devices. Next, I will replace this first window, which I set up as a subscriber with a small Wi-Fi device named ESP8266. I will program ESP8266 as a MQTT client so that it can receive message from the publishers for a particular topic such as test. Based on the message received, ESP8266 can perform certain operation such as turning on or off the light or any electrical devices. For this video, I will be using the inbuilt LED of ESP8266 to turn it on and off based on the MQTT message.
This is ESP8266, a small Wi-Fi device which I will program to use as an MQTT client. This small device has several GPIO pins, which can be used to control external appliances or sensors. There are several ways to program this device. Most common ways are either using Arduino IDE with C++ or Micropython. In this video, I will be using Micropython to program this device.
In order to set up Micropython in ESP8266, you must have Python installed in your machine. Then you have to install two libraries in your machine using pip command. First one is ESPtool. So you need to write down pip install ESPtool. In my case, it is already installed, but if you are doing it for the first time, you have to install it. Second, you have to install Adafruit MP. This is also installed in my system. Next, you need to download the Micropython firmware for ESP8266. So for this, you need to go to micropython.org website. Then go to download. Then select your board. This is ESP8266 in my case. And then I have to choose the category of the board. So the nodemcu always have 2 MB plus flash memory. So we have to select 2 MB plus flash memory. And under this category, we'll have a lot of firmwares available. So I will suggest to download the latest firmware, which is 1.17.
Now, after downloading the firmware, you need to connect the ESP8266 with your computer using the USB cable. So this is micro USB port, and after you connect the ESP8266, you can see a blue light flash here.
Next, you need to check the port number where ESP8266 is connected. To get this port number, you need to open Device Manager of your computer. Then you have to check for the ports COM LPT. If you expand, then in my case, this is the ESP8266 driver which is installed, and the port number is COM3. So I will be using this port number to erase and write flash memory of ESP8266. Now, first I will erase the existing firmware of ESP8266. So to do that, I will use ESPtool .py followed by the port number, which is COM3 in my case, then erase _ flash. Now this will erase the flash memory of ESP8266. Next, I will upload the Micropython firmware to ESP8266. So I'll be using the same ESPtool.py followed by port, then write flash flash size equal to detect 0, and then I will put the firmware file, the bin file that we have downloaded previously. Now, this will take a while to upload the firmware to ESP8266 flash memory. Now, ESP8266 is ready for MicroPython programming. This is a simple MicroPython code I have written for this project, where I set up the Mqtt server. This is the IP address of Mqtt server. Then I define a client ID. Client ID is unique for each device. Then I define the Mqtt topic. In my case, it is test, and then Wi-Fi SSID and password. In this line, I define the pin number 2, which is GPIO2 of ESP8266 as an output mode. This GPIO2 of ESP8266 is connected to the inbuilt LED. So I'll be using inbuilt LED to turn it on and off based on the message I received. Next, in this method, I define the Wi-Fi connectivity. After that, I define the Mqtt callback service. So when this device receives message, then it will check the topic and the message. So based on the topic and the message, it will turn on the LED or turn off the LED. Next, under the try catch block, first I initialize the pin, the GPIO pin with the high value. Okay. And then I connect to the Wi-Fi. Then I'm initializing the Mqtt client. Okay. Then I'm setting up the callback service. Okay. And then the Mqtt is connected. And last, I'm start subscribing the message for that particular topic, in my case, which is test. Okay, so after that, under a continuous while loop, I'm waiting for the new message coming from the Mqtt server. Okay, so once Mqtt server sends the message from the other client, this particular client will receive the message and then it will call the callback service. So under the callback service, the topic and message will be checked, and based on the topic and message, it will turn on the LED or turn off the LED. Now this code I saved with the name main.py. Now this is very important in MicroPython. We have to save the main Python file with the name main.py. And this is the file which will be triggered automatically once you power on the ESP8266. After finishing the code, I'll be uploading the main.py file into ESP8266. To do that, I'll be using the Adafruit mp command. mp minus p followed by the port number. First, I will check the directory structure of ESP8266 with ls minus l command. So now, as you can see, currently we have only one file present in ESP8266. Next, I will be uploading the main.py file using mp minus p followed by port number, then put followed by the full path of the main.py file. Now, the main.py file has been uploaded to ESP8266. We can verify with the ls-l command. So as you can see, currently we have two files, boot.py and main.py. Once we power on the ESP8266, the boot.py will get executed for the first time, and then it executes the main.py. If you put any other name in the Python file, it will not going to execute. So we have to put the main.py as a name of the main Python file. Now I open one SSH window of Raspberry Pi. This SSH window I'll be using as a publisher. So from here I will publish message, and ESP8266 will receive the message and turn on the LED or turn off the LED based on the message. So let's start with Mosquitto pub. Followed by the topic test, followed by the message. If I send the message on, it will turn on the LED. So as you can see, the LED is turned on. Now the same message, or in the same command, I'll change the message from on to off. This will turn off the inbuilt LED. This way, we can establish communication between devices with MQTT protocol. With this MQTT protocol concept, we can build IoT applications such as home automations and other IoT applications. So in my next video, I will start a project of building DIY home automation system, and I will be using MQTT server as one of its components. You can get all this code and step-by-step process in the description and in my GitHub page. So stay tuned. Till then, thank you and bye.